Most people in America get sick to death of immature, ill-will, ill-behaving employees at companies. In today's corporate training, we're going to talk about you in every way. You're going to hate it, you're going to like it, you're going to love it, you're going to laugh at it, you're going to not believe some of the shit that we have to tell you about, but the truth is, if I'm that guttural, if I'm that real, you might get your job today. Your job as a manager of our company is to properly train our employees, because every single day our employees represent our company in every way, and every single day your employees have the right to be sued by a customer today. I want to make it really clear that no company is going to protect your little ass for your improper, illegal, immoral behavior in any way with a guest or customer in our store today. Do you have your attention now geared to what I'm talking about today? Are you plugged in well enough with your ears today? Because what we're going to talk about is immoral behavior. What we're going to talk about is the breaches of human rights. What we're going to talk about is sexually improper behavior on the job. And what we're going to talk about is human touch today. We have men and women who come from immoral communities who do not know the rules of propriety in a business today. At no time do you ever have the right to physically put your hands on anyone in our company today, whether they are a fellow employee or whether they're a guest in our shop. I'm going to tell you about this man named Mitchell who illegally put his hands on an impoverished man in our community, and as a result, our company is now in a $1 million lawsuit for physical assault, sexual abuse, and improper harassment of that individual. Does that make sense to you? Probably not. You see, that man refused to take the indigent person's money. He tried several times to pay for the food he wanted to buy. As a result, not only was the food delivered improperly and inefficiently and not properly to the standard that the gentleman requested it and ordered it, but that individual refused on behalf of his alleged wife, who is the manager of the shop, to take his money. That pissed him off. But at the same time of his rights being ruined and rights being denied to pay for our food, that assistant manager, the husband of that wife team, their nepotism was flourishing, and that their daughter worked there, their son worked there, who God knows, their cousin might have worked there, their nephew might have worked there, that openly that man decided to double tap the arm of that homeless man. A double tap is a way in which someone can get someone to be distracted so something can be stolen from them if they've been programmed like that by law enforcement or some sexual predator. At this time, the man is now missing a monocular out of his pockets. At the same time, the homeless man looked at that man with the disdain of any man that says, "Don't fucking touch me," but that boy did it again. We call him a boy because he's definitely over 30. He definitely is old enough to know better, but he's put our company in a major lawsuit. So let us be clear, at no time do you have the right to tap or touch any customer or any visitor in our store. You're a big enough boy or girl to use your words to say, "Excuse me, please, I understand you're looking for me," or "Excuse me, please, I'd like to do this for you." But if a customer says no, it means no, motherfucker, and you're going to pay attention to my anger because we are now in that lawsuit. Some of our employees have participated in that too. Some of our employees on the block have participated in that. Some of our even stupid-ass garbage truck employees have been participating in stealing from that homeless person, abating the laws of our city that says every person of every walk and every style and every financial worth has rights in our community.